So as we're talking about the blood drive, we wanted to talk with these students. We wanted to show a couple of videos, and we wanted to get their reaction. And so first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk to you guys and say, okay, do you know why we donate blood?
I think the reason why people donate blood is to help people in need that needs blood.
Yep, absolutely. Absolutely. So here's the thing. So medical science has come a long way. One of the things they cannot do in a lab is make blood. That requires people helping other people. And so there are some folks that have certain diseases that they're born with that they need transfusions throughout their lifetime. Some people experience catastrophic accidents. We have a video here that we wanted to show you and get your reaction. We're going to first of all learn about Tamia, who's a young lady who the Red Cross put on film because she has a condition called sickle cell disease.
I have sickle cell disease. Sometimes I can't do the activities that I love to do, and it puts obstacles in front of me, but I don't let that define who I am.
Some days she wake up with her feet hurting or her back hurting. She's not able to play softball. She's not able to play soccer because if she gets hit, it can put her into a crisis.
It's hard to live like this because I see normal kids and sometimes I can't go to school and I just want to be like them.
It's very hurtful to watch your child suffer so badly, and you can't even help.
When I get a blood transfusion, it makes me feel 100% better. I am back to my normal self.
You can actually watch her life come back to her. Her color comes back, her strength come back, her ability to be able to walk, feed herself, it all comes back after just that one blood transfusion. I remember the time when Maya had to go in the hospital and the blood was not there, and it was the scariest, most frantic moment in our lives.
I was very sick, but I was mostly worried that the blood wouldn't come in time.
I just tell her, I need you to fight, because we're going to find it. And they came in finally and said, Mom, we found it. And I cried. I had to go in the restroom and cry.
That blood means a lot to me. Without the American Red Cross donors, I wouldn't be here right now.
I am so grateful for those people that roll up a sleeve, those blood donors that take the time out of their busy schedule to donate blood to the American Red Cross to give my child or any child that's receiving blood another chance at life to be able to grow up.
So just thank you very much.
So what'd you guys think of that?
I think it was real sad. I was getting a little emotional, just a little bit.
So it impacted you.
Yeah.
I feel like we shouldn't take life for granted because some people have it worse than us.
All right, I got one more video that I want to play here.
Why have you never donated blood before?
Intimidated to go in.
Needles are probably going to be...
Just gonna check your veins.
There's no needles yet. Well, I have a very special helper here today that I think might be able to help you through the process.
Really?
Oh, hi.
Well, hi there.
Are you scared?
A little nervous.
Well, I'm gonna help you get through it today.
You ready to get started?
Hold your hand.
Yes, please. Thank you.
It's okay.
If you want to hold my friend AJ, if you can.
Thank you.
Eye contact.
All right.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting cow.
Interrupting cow.
Move.
Girl, I love your ripped jeans. Are your knees a little cold?
One, two,
three.
One, two,
Dang it.
Miss Emma, you are almost there.
Wow. Girl, you're almost done.
I should bring you every time I get a shot.
Well, there's actually a reason your helper here today is so familiar with the blood donation process.
So I have a blood disease that is called sickle cell anemia type SS. I've been hospitalized over 72 times and have blood transfusions over 70 times.
When I was 5 months old, I went into kidney failure. I needed to have a lot of blood transfusions.
And when I get the blood transfusions, it makes me feel like I'm me again, like I'm a kid, I can do anything.
Thank you for donating from the bottom of my heart.
And girl, give me a hug.
Well, I think everything we've talked about that kept my focus the most.
And not only I'm thankful, but my mom is too.
On behalf of whoever's gonna get your blood, thank you so much. It means so much to us.
Without you, she would not be here.
Thank you so much.
Group hug.
This makes it 1,000,000% worthwhile. I'm literally honored and privileged to be able to do this.
Would you do it again?
I would happily do it again.
I feel like we should pinky promise.
You're all done.
I can hug you with both arms.
What did you guys think of that?
It was happy but sad at the same time. Like, I was happy that they was giving blood, but talking about what she got and how many times she had to be hospitalized is crazy.
Yeah, they almost buried the lead, didn't they? They almost should have led with that, right? the fact that we see Tamia when she's young and we learn about her illness and then we watch a video of her older, you can see how those transfusions have helped her, right?
Yeah.
It just gave me a better understanding of why it's more important to, you know, give blood to the ones in need, because like they go through a lot throughout their lifetime, and for me just to, you know, have it easy, I don't see why I shouldn't, you know, be able to give blood to the ones in need.
So our theme this year is your uniquely renewable resource. And so to me, that sort of talks about two things. One, we have the resources that fuel us, the renewable resources like the sun, the wind, the water and plants, all things that are renewable, and they fuel us. And then we have a renewable resource in ourselves that we can donate to help people in situations like Tamia's or like people who are in catastrophic accidents. Is that something that might inspire you to want to donate?
Yeah.
So the other component of that is unique. You're uniquely renewable resource. And while there's different blood types, we also know that there's 600 different antigens in blood, and we need to have blood donors from all walks of life, right? From every ethnicity, race, because we know that there's better outcomes if they receive blood from somebody else who is of the same ethnic background as they are. And so do you think you're inspired to donate when we have the blood drive in Clinton Township? Mm-hmm. The Clinton Township blood drive is going to be here with the Red Cross on February 9th from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. Thank you for being here. Thank you for participating in this and helping us tell the public. So we look forward to seeing you here on February 9th.